Hi, I'm Dr. Ling, consultant pediatrician from Thompson Hospital, Kota Damansara in Malaysia. Okay, in many countries, vaccination against COVID for children and adolescents are already underway. For quite some time now, the default vaccine would be Pfizer, as it is the only brand that has approval for the younger age group. In Malaysia, the government has also approved the use of the Sinovac vaccine for adolescents and children. Okay, so which one should I choose? Pfizer or Sinovac? Okay, what I'll do now is to give you a comparison between these two vaccines so that as parents, we can make an informed decision as to which vaccine we would give to our kids. I will also tell you why I believe boys should consider taking Sinovac. Okay, firstly, we'll look into the immunogenicity and effectiveness of the vaccine. Essentially, immunogenicity is the capacity of the vaccine to cause our bodies to produce neutralizing antibodies against the COVID virus. On the other hand, vaccine effectiveness looks into how effective the vaccine really is in real life in preventing diseases or deaths. Both vaccines showed good immunogenicity and produced neutralizing antibodies even in adolescents. However, Pfizer caused a much higher antibody response of 1,300 GMTs or geometric mean titers that was even higher level compared to Pfizer used in adults. Sinovac produced only 140 GMTs, which was almost 10 times lower. It is actually very difficult to determine what antibody level constitutes protection. Sinovac's antibody level, while lower, might very well still be very potent in providing protection. Of course, if given a choice, we would rather have a higher than a lower antibody response. With regard to vaccine effectiveness, data among children and adolescents, Pfizer has their vaccine effectiveness data, which showed high protection against serious illness and death of more than 90%. This is compared to the Sinovac studies, which only had immunogenicity data, but did not have any vaccine effectiveness data. Nevertheless, based on Malaysia's vaccine effectiveness data, Pfizer can reduce ICU admission and death by 93%, while Sinovac is able to reduce ICU admission by 77% and deaths by 84%. So both vaccines showed high vaccine effectiveness, though Pfizer appears to have more impressive results. These data, however, are among adults and not children. Okay, next we look into the side effects of the vaccine. All vaccines would have side effects. Those mild side effects are not what we are concerned about. What we are concerned are the serious side effects. Based on data from Singapore, the incidence rate of serious adverse events among those who took the Pfizer or Moderna vaccine was 0.005%, while that for Sinovac was 0.004%, both of which are comparable to the rate of serious side effects of conventional vaccines. So serious events occur at a rate of about 1 in 20 to 25,000. And the most common serious adverse events are severe allergic reactions, known as anaphylaxis. Now, many parents are concerned regarding the heart inflammation or myocarditis side effects. This side effect is seen with mRNA vaccine like Pfizer, but not with the Sinovac vaccine. The overall incidence of vaccine-induced myocarditis is nevertheless very low, about 1 in 50 to 100,000. However, boys have a higher incidence compared to girls, and myocarditis tend to occur on the second dose. For girls, incidence of myocarditis is 1 in 100,000, while for boys who take the second dose, the incidence is 1 in 20,000. Almost all who developed myocarditis had mild illness and made uneventful recovery. Even so, the long-term effects of the myocarditis is still not known. Okay, so we know both Pfizer and Sinovac have good immunogenicity and vaccine effectiveness, but Pfizer is superior, We also know both have comparable rates of serious adverse events, but Pfizer has side effects of myocarditis, which is more common in boys. So which vaccine do we choose for our children? For those at risk of severe COVID, those with chronic diseases such as that of heart, lung and kidney, those with immunodeficiency and those with comorbidities like obesity, we want the most effective vaccine. The choice is obvious, Pfizer. For healthy girls, since the risk of adverse events are similar between Pfizer and Sinovac and the incidence of myocarditis in girls is very low, we go for a more effective vaccine. So the choice for girls, Pfizer. How about for healthy boys? Well, due to the higher risk of myocarditis in boys for the Pfizer vaccine, as parents, we might want to consider giving Sinovac to our boys. This is at a compromise of a slight reduction in protection from COVID. Okay, but let's put it this way. The risk of severe COVID in healthy children is already very low to start off with. So a little lower protection will not make much difference anyway. It's like an analogy of driving a car and a risk of accidents. If you're an elderly person or with comorbidities, you have high risk of severe COVID. It's like driving a Formula One car on a racetrack with high risk of accidents. So you want to put on the best protection with helmets, seat belts, and anti-fire suit. So you would take Pfizer. But if you are a child, you have low risk of severe COVID. So it's like driving a normal car on a normal road with lower risk of accidents. You need protection with a seat belt, but you need not have the whole works like that of a Formula One race driver. So for children, protection with Sinovac could be sufficient. Even so, it would also be a perfectly reasonable choice to take Pfizer for our boys. The risk of myocarditis and other serious adverse events is after all still really low. If you're okay with the myocarditis risk, then go ahead and take Pfizer. But if the myocarditis is a big concern for you, then take Sinovac. Then there is also the practical issue of vaccine passport. Currently, many countries, especially in the West, have yet to recognize Sinovac as an approved vaccine. Therefore, travel to these countries could be met with more hassle for those who have taken Sinovac. Nevertheless, more and more countries have begun accepting Sinovac as the approved vaccine, and I'm positive this may not be a big issue in the near future. Okay, that's it for this segment. Take care, stay safe, and continue to have a heart for kids.